we'll talk about the safety first ratio and Roy's criterion for portfolio optimization. Very well. Here's the safety first ratio. Does it remind you of another familiar ratio? That's right. It is almost identical to the Sharpe ratio. However, instead of R sub F, the risk-free rate, we use R sub L, which is the threshold level return. When calculating the Sharpe ratio, we compare against the risk-free rate. Whereas when applying the safety first ratio, we are interested in seeing the portfolio performance against a minimum acceptable level, under which we don't want to fall. Let's calculate the safety first ratio in practice. This is a situation when our R sub L, the threshold level return, is 0%. I know, it's a bit strange, but let's go ahead with the example. A portfolio's historical average return is 15%, and it has a standard deviation of 20%. How much is the safety first ratio of this portfolio? Well, it is equal to 15% minus 0% divided by 20%. This gives us 0.75. Okay, now let's introduce Roy's safety first criterion. According to this rule, an optimal portfolio minimizes the probability of obtaining a return that goes under a certain minimum acceptable level. If portfolio returns are normally distributed, Roy's safety first criterion translates in maximizing the safety first ratio. To satisfy Roy's criterion, in case we have a second portfolio, we would need to calculate its safety first ratio. Then compare the results of the two portfolios given and choose the one that has a more favorable ratio. Assume that you have to choose between the portfolio we already considered and a second portfolio that has a historical average return of 5% and a standard deviation of 8%. We'll have 5% minus 0% divided by 8%. The safety ratio of the second portfolio is 0.62, which is lower than 0.75 for the first portfolio. Therefore, the first portfolio is preferable, according to Roy's safety first criterion. But how do we find the probability that the first portfolio's return would be lower than the threshold level R sub L? Well, we need to satisfy the safety first ratio of 0.75 and calculate N of minus 0.75, which is actually equal to 1 minus N of 0.75. Using the z-score table, we'll be able to see that N of 0.75 is 0.7734. And hence, we would have 1 minus 0.773, and this equals 0.227. Excellent work!